music from one of Bach's most iconic works for keyboard, his Italian Concerto. We heard the opening movement performed by Glenn Gould. It is 6 minutes after 12 o'clock. Happy Friday, everyone. This is Intermezzo, brought to you by the Fort Garry Hotel. I'm Claudia Garcia de la Huerta. The show is brought to you by the historic Fort Garry Hotel. Well, one of my favorite things about the hotel is the Palm Lounge, located right on the main level there. If you've never been, you are missing out. Big comfortable chairs, great food and beverages, great service, and more importantly, great live entertainment basically every night of the week. Tonight and tomorrow night, the Palm Lounge welcomes back saxophone player and smooth jazz king Walle Larsson, and I'm so excited to say that he is in the studio with me. Welcome to Classic 107.
Well, thanks, Claudia. That's quite the title you're giving me. I hope I can live up to it.
This is not your first time at Classic 107, but it's been a really long time. It's really nice to see you. What have you been up to?
Well, still just playing the saxophone and flute and packing a suitcase and hopping on airplanes and going to whatever gigs I can get and whoever will hire me.
Now, you've just come back from a European tour.
I have. Yeah, I spent just about 3 weeks in Romania on a touring bus and pretty well every major city in Romania playing concerts in soft cedars and opera houses. And
what was that like?
Oh, it was really incredible. The musicians over there, the young musicians are great, very talented. And I was just blessed to have that connection and be able to meet up with them and have a successful tour. I'm hoping to go back for a Christmas tour as well.
So did you play with a particular group of musicians, or were there different people at every stop?
No, we had an agent sort of put a group of musicians together for me, and they were the musicians for the whole tour, and they worked out really great. We got along fabulously, so those are the guys that I'll be joining again, hopefully around Christmas, for a Christmas tour.
And so how do the audiences differ in Europe and when you're playing it here in North America?
You know, it's a little different scene over in Europe. They've just come back from communism 30 years ago, so I think people are relieved to just have the freedom to have a latte, buy their groceries and their bottle of wine, and enjoy life. It's a lot different from the scene here of, you know, going to Costco and buying a week's worth of supplies and hunkering down. And, it's just a totally different lifestyle.
Now, speaking of different lifestyles, we can't really call you one of our own anymore. You've been based in California for a while now.
Yeah, my wife and I, you know, started gravitating towards California a few years ago. I started having some opportunities down there. We bought a place down there. Now that my kids are out of the nest, I'm down there full time right now. But you never know, that could change too. But I'm enjoying it for now.
Well, I'm glad that you always find time to come back home.
Oh, absolutely. You know, like we were saying earlier, we all sort of point the bus home at some time, back to Winnipeg.
It's that thing about Winnipeg, no matter where you are in the world, it always pulls you back in.
That's right.
So tell me about the show that you're going to be performing tonight and tomorrow night at the Fort Garry.
Well, you know, I'm just, I feel really glad and blessed that Michelle Wood, who books all the entertainment at the Fort Garry Lounge, I'm just glad that she hasn't lost my phone number, because we keep in touch. I let her know, you know, once a year or so when I pass through town. She fits me into the schedule. So the Palm Lounge is just such a great place to play, you know, especially in the day of like sports bars with 12 TVs in the room and football games going on. The Palm Lounge is a place to relax and just come down and take it easy. So the decor there, the acoustics and the whole vibe, and like you were saying earlier, the service and everything else makes it really conducive to just go in there and play some jazz, invite some friends down, and just celebrate the Fort Garry Hotel, music in Winnipeg, and just a chance to get together.
You know what it feels like, Walle? Sometimes when I walk into the hotel, it's like you're walking back through time, and just because of the hotel itself and what it looks like. And so I think it helps you just shut everything off. You've just sort of walked into another space and time, and you can sit back and really focus on enjoying, you know, what whoever's performing there. There's something very special about that place.
Yeah, Claudia, you know, My history with hotels like that, I started my career at the Chateau Lake Louise out in Alberta. So the railroad hotels hold a special place in my heart. And kudos to those that have restored them and maintained them. And, you know, just keep that history going, because you're absolutely right. You walk in and, you know, the pristine conditions and the decor of the Fort Garry Hotel are just stunning.
Mm-hmm. So what will you be performing this weekend? Because you're performing with two different musicians while you're on both nights.
Right. You know, the musicians I'm performing with are musicians I've played with a lot over the years, and also two of my best friends. Jordan Jackie will be on piano with me tonight, and Grant Jones will be with me on guitar tomorrow night. So what we'll be doing, because it's just the two of us tonight with Jordan Jackie, we'll be doing tunes just as a duo, just piano and sax and flute, doing some improvising, playing some jazz standards. But we'll also be playing with some backing tracks of some of my smooth jazz hits and some of the tunes that we can't play. We don't have the opportunity to have the full band in. So we'll be doing a few things with backing tracks, taking some requests, and of course, if anybody's got a birthday or a special occasion, we'll take care of that too.
Nice. Yeah. Well, it is so nice to have you back, Walle. Any plans to come back again this summer?
Yes, I'll be back June 22nd for the Winnipeg Jazz Festival.
Nice.
And then I have a couple of private events happening in July. And then I'm going to be playing at Assiniboine Park, I think, Thursday. It's August the 3rd or 4th. I'm doing a concert there with Jennifer Hansen, actually.
We'll
playing with me, too. So, yeah, a few things to come back and, you know, just celebrate some friendships and get back to town and enjoy the pig.
We love Jennifer Hansen here. We're so happy she's back in Winnipeg.
Hey, we all come
and
back, right?
Yeah, see, speaking of.
That's
and,
right.
There's a voice who, she just gets better and better.
That's right.
So I'm looking forward to.
Just like a fine wine,
exactly,
right?
Exactly, exactly. And you too, Walle, like a fine wine, seriously.
Oh, I appreciate it, Claudia. Thank you so much for having me.
My pleasure. We're going to play a bit of your music. I've picked a piece that I quite like called Walking Through the Valley. Do you want to introduce it? Tell us a bit about it.
Sure. It's interesting. You know, I think, you know, life is a challenge for all of us, and we all have certain things that we go through either relationally, health-wise, financially, or, you know, different valleys that we go through. I don't think anybody escapes it. So that's really a song about, you know, being in the valley, but, you know, I'm a man of faith, so I always have faith that we're going to walk through that valley and come to a better place. And I think that's true with most of us, and I think it's a good way to look at that. Have faith for things improving.
I love that. Walle Larsson, Walking Through the Valley. If you want to see him live, he is performing tonight and tomorrow night at the Fort Garry Hotel. And this, not really quite what you're going to hear at the hotel, but a taste of Walle Larsson.